Stephen William Hawking's, an English theoretical physicist, cosmologist, and author who lived from 8th of January 1942 to 14th of March 2018, was the director of research at the Center for Theoretical Cosmology at the University of Cambridge up to his death. He was the Lucasian Professor of Mathematics at the University of Cambridge between 1979 to 2009. At a very young age of just 21, Hawking was diagnosed with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, a slow-progressing form of motor neuron disease, which was suspected to lead him to death within a few years, but ultimately gradually paralyzed him over the decades. The paralyzed Hawking, despite his disability, stopped nowhere. Even with the help of a wheelchair, he continued to enjoy his life. He is best known for his dozens of theories. Some of them are Hawking's radiation, a brief history of time, black hole information paradox, no hair theorem, Hawking's energy, Gibbon-Hawking's effect, and many more. His work and efforts in the field of science and mathematics have been appreciated by the wise people with a number of awards. For example, Adams Prize, Eddington's Medal, Hahnemann's Prize, Albert Einstein Award, RAS Gold Medal, Wolf Medal, Presidential Medal of Freedom, etc. He always used to consider himself a child. He often used to say, "I am just a child who has never grown up. I still keep asking these how and why questions. Occasionally, I find an answer." Now, with a heart full of gratitude and a mind full of positivity, let us try to understand and analyze how this disabled man could change his disability into something differently abled. Let us try to see how can we motivate ourselves towards the positive aspects of our lives. However difficult life may seem, there is always something you can do and succeed at. I have noticed even people who claim everything is predestined and that we can do nothing to change it look before they cross the road. We are in danger of destroying ourselves by our greed and stupidity. We cannot remain looking inwards at ourselves on a small and increasingly polluted and overcrowded planet. In my opinion, there is no aspect of reality beyond the reach of the human mind. Work gives you meaning and purpose, and life is empty without it. Life would be tragic if it weren't funny. When one's expectations are reduced to zero, one really appreciates everything one does have. People won't have time for you if you are always angry or complaining. The past, like the future, is indefinite and exists only as a spectrum of possibilities. Intelligence is the ability to adapt to change. I think the brain is essentially a computer, and consciousness is like a computer program. It will cease to run when the computer is turned off. Theoretically, it could be recreated on a neural network, but that would be very difficult as it would require all one's memories. We are just an advanced breed of monkeys on a minor planet of a very average star, but we can understand the universe that makes us something very special. There is nothing bigger or older than the universe. Look up at the stars and not down at your feet. Try to make sense of what you see and wonder about what makes the universe exist. Be curious. I believe things cannot make themselves impossible. I believe the universe is governed by the laws of science. The laws may have been decreed by God, but God does not intervene to break the laws. I think computer viruses should count as life. I think it says something about human nature that the only form of life we have created so far is purely destructive. We have created life in our own image. Success in creating AI would be the biggest event in human history. Unfortunately, it might also be the last, unless we learn how to avoid the risks. We only have to look at ourselves to see how intelligent life might develop into something we would not want to meet. My advice to other disabled people would be, concentrate on things your disability doesn't prevent you doing well, and don't regret the things it interferes with. Don't be disabled in spirit as well as physically.